Hey everybody, welcome back to another edition of Unscripted Gibberish. Today, again, we take care for some comments. And yeah, on my last video, I noticed that I always tend to turn my head to the right. That's for a reason. I'm sure you didn't know that. Now I tell you. On my left eye, the power of view is only about 30 to 40%. So I'm more or less blind on my left side. And that's also the reason why when I walk with somebody on the streets, I always walk on the left side because, I simply can see better what's on my right side. So that's why I put my camera to the right. Maybe today it works. First comment. Just a note, you do not pronounce the TH in clothes. Most Germans I've met pronounce it incorrectly, which it to native speakers sounds stupid. Drop the TH and pronounce it like close, as in close the door. Good advice. First of all, I'm not perfect in English. How could I? I'm German. Second, for a non-native English speaker, English sometimes is a little funny. And I make fun about it. And when I say clothes and spit, could also be a part of fun. I don't know, but on the other hand, I have never met any native English speaker who can pronounce the German language perfectly. Try Eichhörnchen. You can't. But on the other hand, I speak Italian, I don't know if you know that, and I'm able to pronounce perfectly well words like latte macchiato, spaghetti, prosciutto, gnocchi. Top that. Next comment. Hi Mike, what's that Compostela picture over your monitor? This is a picture I bought in 2016. It was from an Italian website called PostaSantiago.com. And this picture is 67 by 97 centimeters. Kind of big. And it's showing in the form of a shell the different caminos leading to Santiago with their entry points, stations, distances. And it also shows a statistic of how the numbers of pilgrims divide up to the single caminos. I like this picture very much. Now, if you want to order it, it's 28 euros plus shipping. I had this delivered less than a week. It was awesome. I once made a video about what I'd take on the Camino, and someone asked, so what about shaving gear? Do you just grow your beard? Let me tell you one thing. When I was younger, I was always dreaming, once I got retired, riding on my Harley with my dad bod and long beard, riding into the sunset. But I can't grow a beard. I don't know why. Some hairs here, some hairs there. And even after a week, makes no sense of shaving. So, in fact, I take shaving gear on the Camino, but only one of this one-way big shavers. You know, the orange plastic ones. Now, when I was younger, people laughed about me like, you are not really a man, Or women like, oh, but I love men with a beard. I see it differently. Now, in former times, when we were still living on a tree, jumping from branch to branch with our friends, body hair made sense. You know, protected us against wind, cold, and even pubic hair protected us from animals getting into body openings. Simple as that. But now we jumped down the tree, evolved, invented clothes. There's no need for body hair anymore. Not even in the face. For what? So I think, evolution wise, I'm much more developed than most of my fellow males. Anyway, next comment. Just seeing the number of your subscribers, you can see they didn't understand the real purpose in our life. Don't let bother you. You know the spirit, and you do it in two languages. Thank you. Again, you know, many people say, why you don't have more subscribers? I know why. Because my videos are not perfect. I know that. It's not for everybody. But on the other hand, let's say it that way. I would like to get my channel monetized. Why not make some money? Some people make a living out of that. Would be awesome. And you know, to get the channel monetized, you have to have at least 1,000 subscribers and a certain amount of view time. Now, the amount of view time, I'm far over it. But I'm lacking subscribers. It is what it is. Now, I don't know, maybe if I said in each of my videos, push the subscribe button and don't forget to push the bell icon to get your notifications. I don't do that. But that shouldn't prevent you from subscribing to my channel. One day I will hit the thousands and then rock and roll. Next one, regarding subscribers. Please don't change this. This way you will only keep the viewers that matter. And that's true. That's true. And that's awesome. You know, I'm always not only surprised, but puzzled and astonished that I got almost no negative comments on my channel. Maybe sometimes one, let's say, try of being negative, but not really. A lot of channels have a lot of haters on them. I don't. You know, when I, some days when I feel a little down, happens always also to me, I scroll through my comments and I'm feeling good. I have gathered such an incredible crowd of people around me. You're awesome. And you are the major reason why I go on doing this. Nice that you left your comfort zone, Camino Frances. I don't think that any Camino is a comfort zone. For me, it's, I know the Camino Frances. But on the other hand, as I mentioned before, every time I'm there, for me it's, apart from some places, for me it's like I'm there for the very first time. It's nothing to do with comfort zone. And the Camino Frances is not easy. Are you going to walk the Frances again? Yes, I will. And I will do next year, and most probably in May. Could be, I don't know. I have to figure out my situation at work. Maybe in April, maybe in June, but around May. And I want to walk the entire way again, say from Saint-Jean-Pied-de-Port to Santiago. I think I will not walk to Fisterra and Mushuya again, simply due to time. I will take, I think, 5 weeks. It's enough, and I want to have some time buffer, you know, maybe if I want to stay at a place or I want to take it a little slower, whatever. So 5 weeks French way next year. Maybe we see us. Would be awesome. It's a pity that in Spain vegetarian or vegan kitchen is not that present. It's true, but it's getting better. You know, when I started in 2015, was almost non-existent. And now, more and more restaurants, especially in the bigger towns like Burgos, Leon, whatever, you find vegan, vegetarian restaurants. And also, more and more albergues offer vegetarian kitchen. So, we get there. I'm not a vegetarian or a vegan, but I like the kitchen, especially when it's made out of fresh things, not this artificial stuff out of the supermarket. That's interesting. You cannot control anything. It's all a matter of fate. We live in the imagination to have control about anything. I don't think so. I don't think so. I think you can have control and you should have control. And you should not allow anybody to take control away from you. Take control, take responsibility. And just, let's say, leaning back and saying, oh, it's all a matter of fate. That's lazy. That's too simple. It's kind of, you blame someone or something else for your own decisions. In this case, fate. It's not fate, it's you. I don't translate this entirely, just the last part that matters. Thank you for your openness in your prior videos, but in particular for this video, it touched my soul. Thank you. It was my video about you have to die a few times before you can really live. Another comment in the same direction. I appreciate your heartfelt honesty and deep introspection and respect you even more than I did before. Yeah. When the pandemic started, I wanted to walk the Camino and I was forced to stay at home 5 weeks. Travel restrictions, you know, locked up. And I was bored. And I started watching YouTube videos. And I found a channel called Camera Conspiracies. It's about cameras. But this guy, he has also some other channels about vegetarian food and stuff like that. Anyway, this guy once said, if you make videos, you have to either teach me something, make me laugh, or make me feel something. If none of this happens, it's boring, I do not watch your videos. And that's what I want to transport here, you know? Feelings, thoughts, honesty. That's why I don't script. You know, the way I talk into the camera would be more or less the same way that I would talk to you sitting in a bar. And I think YouTube is full of very nice videos. But not much honesty, and not much feelings, many feelings. I'm very good at English, I know that. But that's a thing that you learn on the Camino, this openness. You find out that there's no reason to keep all your emotions inside. Why not let it out? There's nothing to be ashamed of. And when you, or if you went through periods of shit in your life, and you're still here, you can be proud of yourself. Don't feel ashamed. Tell people about your life. Let them take part. And on the other hand, this guy, Casey, from Camera Conspiracies, made me buy my Sony X3000. Best Camino camera ever built. You cannot buy it new now. I don't think so. It's not on stock anymore. It's model 2016. No better camera ever. If you can get it on eBay used, buy it. You cannot go wrong. Next one. You make me love so much. I'm in love with you. Thank you. That's it so far. Another entertaining Saturday for me. I don't know, how about you? Anyway, next time, I don't know. We will see. I don't plan anything, you know. I'm done so far. Buen Camino.